Hello and welcome to this tutorial. Here we will be discussing the working of a perturb and observe maximum power point tracking method for solar photovoltaic panel. So in any photovoltaic panel, we know that our photovoltaic power and voltage curve, which is like this, it shifts the maximum power point with the change in irradiance and temperature. So we need some tracking method that can efficiently track the maximum power across the whole day operation. During the whole day operation, we have a semicircular curve of irradiation, where this is the sunrise and this is the sunset, and same is our temperature curve that varies with the increase in irradiation. So now during the course of a whole day, this change in irradiance will dynamically change these PV curves. Therefore, we need to have some tracking method. So there are various types of methods available in our literature to track the maximum power point. However, this perturb and observe, or the P&O, very commonly known as the perturb and observe P&O, or the hill climbing method, is one such method where we can compute the maximum power at any irradiation condition. So let us see how this works. So first of all, let us have the flow chart of this P&O algorithm. So the flow chart is very simple. We have an initial value of the duty cycle D, that is at the start we measure this. Then what we do is this: we measure the power. How we can get the power? Power is equal to V cross I. So we have, if we have this type of photovoltaic module, so we will, what we are going to measure is, we are going to measure the current I and the voltage between these two points. So when we measure them, the power is equal to V cross I. So we measure the instantaneous power by multiplying the voltage and the current. So when we get this P, we call it a P new, because this is after we have executed, this is the first cycle, so this is the new power. So what happened is, next we have perturb the operating point. So the initial operating point was D, let us suppose at the start the T is 0.5, and we have a perturbation value of delta D, which is a step size, that how much change in D is desired before we can observe the change in our output power. So let us suppose D is really small, let us consider it 0.01. so here we will be having plus delta of D. So after we, this is on us, we can also have a negative perturbation initially, but let us start conventionally by applying this, that after measuring this P new, if this D is equal to 0.5, we will add a 0.01 here, and the next thing is actually a decision block where we have a condition. We will see what this condition actually works. This is P new. We will see if the new power is greater than P old or not. Now if it is the first perturbation cycle, then there is no P stored, so the P old is equal to 0. So obviously when we measure it, this P new is greater than P old. So if it is greater than P old, what we will go? We will go back here and we will again have an increment of plus T. But before going back, we will update a little thing. Let us draw this again. Before going again to this point, it will update this value of D. So now it is not going to the start of this program, but it is updating the value of D, which was initially D is equal to 0.5, but now after this 0.01, it is D is equal to D will be equal to 0.501. so it will again check this. If it is greater than, it will add 0.01 here, and if P new is greater than P old, it will again keep on updating this value of D. Now what will happen if at some point this P new is not greater than P old? Then at that instant, it will be a no sign here, then we will perturb in the opposite direction. That opposite direction will be minus of delta D. So if it is if this value is less than zero, if the P nu is less than P old, we will perturb in the opposite direction, and we will go through minus D. So this minus D, after perturbing, it will again, you know, compare the comparison between the P nu and P old. Now if it is greater than or less than if P nu is greater than P old, then we will again update the value of D. That will be with minus D now. So if at this point, if it was 0.501, we will also be having this D is equal to 0.501 here, because this one 0.502 and it was less, so it will go here, update this value, and will keep on performing in this loop. Now if P nu is not greater than P old, then what will happen? It will go back and it will operate here. So let us see now how it works on our curve. So if this is our let us draw a typical photovoltaic curve. Let us consider that initially our duty cycle was 0.5 and our delta D is equal to 0.01, and what will happen, how it will proceed. So when we started our system at D is equal to 0.5, we assume that our system was operating at, just a minute, let me select this appropriate point at this instant. So this is the initial point, let us call it a initial point when we started our system. So after this it will increase, because first we say that the first perturbation is equal to plus delta D. So it is D plus delta D. So after adding 0.01 in this condition, let us suppose that we reach at this point. This is our point number 2. So this, let us call it P0, let us call it P1. So now at this instant we can see that P1 is greater than P0, so we will keep on following this D is equal to D plus delta D. So again we will be operating in the same loop, which is this loop. We are not going to shift from this loop unless and until this conditional statement is held wrong. So for Y, we are always going to have a positive delta D here. So we will be having another increment here, and we operate at P3. Now again, that P2 is greater than P1. Therefore, again, we will be having delta is equal to D plus delta D. Now, after this, you will again perturb, and we will reach at point P3. Now P3 is greater than P2, therefore the condition will be D plus delta D. Now we have started from 0.05, right? So again we will be having another perturbation, and we will be having here P4. Now again P4 is greater than P3, therefore it is D plus delta D. Now after this point, you can see this is our maximum power. The maximum power is not far away from this P4, and this is our maximum power point. So we have to track this maximum power point. Now if we have the fifth alteration here, let us suppose after this fifth alteration it comes here at this point, so this will be our P5. Now if, because there is this slope, if we zoom in this slope, it is something like this. So this is our maximum power point. Here we were at the P4, and here we might fall here, or we might fall here depending on the step size. So if we, first of all, we assume that we fall at this instant, which is P5. So then P5 is greater than P4, because obviously at this instant, this is P5 is greater than this P4, so it will again go for D plus delta D. But for that thing, when this is P5, you applied another transition here, and we fall here. This is a very sharp steep curve. Now P5 is less than P6, therefore at this instant we will be having a negative delta D from now onward, because the power difference is not in our in increasing power, it is not decreasing, because this P5 after perturbing in the, because this algorithm is not intelligent enough to know that it has surpassed this maximum power point. It always works with the difference in the previous power and the instantaneous power after the perturbation. Therefore at this instant, when we have this P5 less than P6, it will change its direction and the D will shift to D minus delta D. Now this D minus delta D will move this P6 to back to P5. Now if it is, now it is back to P5, so we will see that now the P5 is greater than P6, therefore the direction will be kept in the negative direction. So it will go on again to this point unless it will see that there is a considerable change in the power. Now if the P5, because the last time we assumed that P5 was greater than P4, now the P5 is less than P4, so in the next direction it will be D plus delta D. So the overall crux is this, that it keeps on oscillating, because if this is our maximum power point curve, this is the knee point MPP here, the algorithm will keep on shifting and oscillating between the maximum power point. So it will go here, it will go here. As a result of it, we will always be having the voltage oscillations like this, right? So where this is the maximum power point, so it will go on and perturb it like this. So we always have an oscillation around this maximum power point, and this is a very serious issue for this perturb and observe method. So how we can tackle this, how we can reduce this oscillation, because these oscillations will ultimately, when multiplied with the value of current, will produce which we assume is constant, these will produce power oscillations around the maximum power point like this, same like this. So these power oscillations are a power loss, because this is the maximum power point, while the time the system is not operating across it is counted as a loss. So in order to cope with this, we have an option, which is we can reduce this D to point to very very small value, 0.001. So very very small value means the oscillation will be between these two points only, which are very close to the maximum power point. So if we confine these limits by reducing the duty cycle, we can reduce the amount of power oscillations. But this has another downfall. The downfall is this, that for every photovoltaic curve, this is the PV curve, if we have a very small duty cycle D, the time required to track the power from this point to this point will be higher. So if you have a small duty cycle, small D means greater time or more time to let us call it time required is we need more time, right? So more time is required to more time for maximum power point tracking. However, and for if we have a larger value of duty cycle, then we have more power oscillations. So these are the two things that are required to that should be kept in mind before optimizing the value of the duty cycle in a particular perturb and observe method. And thank you very much. If you have any question, you can post them in the comments box. Thank you very much.